Hello children, welcome for today's biology class. So today we are going to continue the chapter strategies for enhancement in food production. The topic going to be covered are that is artificial insemination, meat, beekeeping and fisheries. First let us study regarding artificial insemination. In this method the semen from the male it is collected and injected inside the reproductive tract of the selected female. Okay, so here the desired male and the desired female is chosen and artificial insemination is done. Here the semen collected, it can be used immediately or it can be frozen and used at a later date also. Next, let us study regarding multiple ovulation embryo transfer technology. Multiple ovulation embryo transfer technology. From name itself you can understand. So here the embryo transfer technology by means of multiple ovulation. First step is multiple ovulation. How it can be done? So here by administering FSH, that is follicle stimulating hormone. So here super ovulation can be done. Super ovulation means production of 6 to 8 eggs per cycle. They call that as super ovulation. So here mainly it is method is used to improve the herd. So in this 6 to 8 eggs are produced by super ovulation and later by means of artificial insemination the eggs are fertilized. So it is allowed to grow up to 8 to 32 cell stage and later it is recovered from the mother, that is wherever it has been grown, and later it is transferred into surrogate mothers. So non-surgically it is taken. Not by means of surgery, without doing surgical method it is taken out and later transferred into surrogate mothers, and the genetic mother once again it can be available for super ovulation. So here we are using one genetic mother and other one is surrogate mother. So this technique it has been successfully it can be used for increasing the good herd in cattle, sheep, rabbit, buffaloes and all it can be used. So it is the flow diagram shown here children. So here cow, we are administering FSH, follicle stimulating hormone. So super ovulation and 6 to 8 eggs per cycle it has been produced. So here it can be bred with the superior bull or it can be known by means of artificial insemination. So we can do fertilization and the embryos are recovered at 8 to 32 cell stage from the genetic mother and later it is transferred into surrogate mother and we are getting the hybrid. Or it can be by means of cryopreservation, that is liquid nitrogen temperature, it can be stored and later it can be utilized. Okay, so simply by drawing the flow diagram also you can explain children. It is very important question. Meat it is asked in 3-mark questions. The artificial insemination it can be asked in 2-mark questions. So study thoroughly. Next let us study regarding beekeeping. Beekeeping is apiculture. So here mainly honey is the main source. Apart from that we are getting wax also from this bees. So honey and wax, these are the two main products we get from here. So different type of varieties of bees are there. Indian bee, rock bee, little bee. So here the Italian bee, no, it is used for large scale production of honey. So actually what do the bees do? They collect nectar from the flowers and it is converting them into honey and storing in beehives. And bees, it can be artificially grown in apiaries. And the honey is extracted by machine called honey extractors. So the mostly used common species known that is Apis indica. So here there is some let us study regarding important tips for beekeeping. First of all, while doing beekeeping, no, you should have knowledge about the bees, nature and the habit of bees. And the selection of suitable location where to keep it has to be. And next to know the catching and hiving of swarms, it is the group of bees. And later the management of beehives, different seasons you should know how to manage that. And you should know how to collect the honey and wax also. So here main purpose use what is that? The bees are the good pollinators. So because of that, no, they increases the yield of the particular species. So brassica, apple, pear. So it is not only for all, it is a good pollinator. So that's why it can be used for increasing the pollination, and it increases the yield, pollination efficiency, and it results in improving the yield. So that's why apart from this, we are getting wax and honey also from the bees. Next is fisheries, that is pisciculture. So fish is also a source of animal protein. So what do we do here? So catching of the fish, processing or selling of the fish. So it can be shellfish or any other aquatic animals. Aquatic animals, it can be prawn or crab, lobster, edible oyster. So all are there. Freshwater fishes are katla, rohu, common carp are coming in this category. Marine fishes, hilsa, sardine, mackerel, pomfrets are coming here. So in coastal area, the fisheries play important role. Mainly it improves the Indian economy as well as income, and it gives many employment to millions of fishermen also. Let us study regarding the differences between pisciculture, mariculture and aquaculture. Pisciculture, it is now fish farming in isolated water bodies. If you do, you call that as pisciculture. So mariculture means farming of aquatic organisms, so in coastal water for commercial use. They call that as mariculture. Aquaculture. So in this, now when culturing of aquatic plants and animals together is done in freshwater bodies, that you call that as aquaculture. So pisciculture, mariculture and aquaculture. These are the differences between these three children. Okay, study thoroughly. We'll meet in the next class. Thank you.